I'm Oscar Brown Jr. on the Jazz Scene, USA. Shelly Manne is one more jazz fool than you can shake a drumstick at. He owns and runs his own jazz club, Shelly's Manhole in Hollywood. On occasion, he's acted in movies. He's probably Hollywood's top recording percussionist, and in his spare time, he breeds show horses on his ranch in San Fernando Valley. It's as leader of his own quintet, though, that he now takes us on a royal romp as the King Swings. Manne has been taking home important awards for jazz drumming for 15 years. Since 1947, he's been honored time and again. What makes Shelly's drumming so special? Well, for one thing, he's one of the most musical drummers ever to make the jazz scene. Shelly's never been content just to keep time for the band. He's always had big, big ears, and he's used his drum virtually as an extra melodic instrument. Shelly's been in the international jazz picture since he joined the Stan Kenton Band. That was in 1946. He was 26 then and had just doffed his wartime Coast Guard uniform the year before. Between 46 and 51, he took time out to work with various other groups, including a tour with Norman Granz's Jazz at the Philharmonic and the 1949 herd of Woody Herman. Shelly's decision to settle in Southern California in 1952 had some pretty far-reaching effects on modern jazz, with Shorty Rogers, Jack Montrose, Jimmy Giuffre, Russ Freeman, and others. He was encouraged to experiment with jazz forms, and so-called West Coast jazz was the result. But Shelly has always insisted that his music has neither West nor East nor any coast, for that matter, is just jazz. And to prove it, here's Shelly Manne and His Men to play Russ Freeman's composition, Fantan. is Shelly Manne, the proud proprietor of the Manhole, and this is Shelly the Manne of many parts. Shelly, welcome to the Jazz.
Thank you, Oscar.
Listen, about this owning your own club? That's pretty unusual for a jazz musician to own and play in his own club, huh?
Well, yes, it is.
What made you want to open your own place?
Well, I wanted a good jazz club where the people could come in and relax and enjoy themselves in a friendly atmosphere and listen to good jazz. And besides that, I wanted a place where I could play with my group all the time. And also, I felt that Los Angeles had enough jazz talent in it to warrant a jazz club to let them show their wares also.
Wonderful. Looks like the Manhole makes a pretty good recording studio, too, huh?
Mm-hmm.
Hey, how about introducing us to the guys in the band?
Sure. On piano, we have Russ Freeman.
Russ, how you doing?
On bass, Monty Budwig.
Monty.
On trumpet, we have Conte Candoli.
Yeah.
And on tenor saxophone, Richie Kamuca.
Hey, wonderful. Thanks, Shelly. And now, from Shelly's Checkmate album, based on the TV show, here is the isolated pawn.
Thank you.
marvels of the American musical theater is the Kurt Weill, Ogden Nash fantasy, One Touch of Venus. And one of the best songs from that show is the enchanting Speak Low, which Shelly Manne and His Men now play. Gentlemen.
Thank you.
that's what's happening on the jazz scene. Until next time, thanks to Shelly Manne and his men for playing, and you for listening and watching. Oscar Brown Jr. here. Later.